Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Main hoon Manish Mishra and in this session I will bring to you five important questions from the PIB News. And guys, in today's session we are going to discuss about the Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra. Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra, and also there is an MOU that has been signed between CSIR and FSSAI. Alright, so a lot to know in today's session, so do watch the complete session. And now let's move on to question number one. So guys, question number 1 and 2 is about the Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra. So let us first discuss about the news. So recently, the Prime Minister of India inaugurated Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra on 8th of August 2020 in the memory of August Kranti. I hope aap sabko pata hoga that 8th August is the anniversary of August Kranti. So on this day, Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra was launched by Prime Minister at the Gandhi Smriti and Darshan Samiti at Rajghat in New Delhi. And guys, it is an interactive experience center on the Swachh Bharat Mission. Swachh Bharat Mission ke upar ye ek interactive experience center hai. And this was dedicated and this was a tribute basically to Mahatma Gandhi by the Prime Minister of India. And these are some key highlights of this Kendras. Like for example, this was first time announced in the year 2070 on 10th of April, which was the centenary celebrations of Gandhiji's Champaran Satyagraha. It was introduced as a Swachh Bharat Mission's successful journey as the world's largest behavior change campaign. It sketches the journey from Satyagraha to Swachhagraha. It showcases the core elements of the mission. It imparts information, awareness and education on Swachhata. And there is also audio-visual immersive shows, interactive LED panels, hologram boxes, interactive games, etc. So these are some key highlights of the Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra. All of these things are included in the Kendras. And if we talk about the Swachh Bharat Mission, guys, so we all know that this mission was launched on 2nd of October 2014 and it has two components. One is Swachh Bharat Mission Urban and one is Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. And this mission was launched for elimination of open defecation, eradication of manual scavenging, modern and scientific municipal solid waste management, and bringing behavioral change regarding healthy sanitation practices. Okay. And if you talk about the Swachh Bharat Mission Urban, so it works under the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. And it recently achieved its target of creating Urban India, the open defecation free. And if you talk about Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen, so it is under the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation, which is now Ministry of Jal Shakti, which is headed by Mr. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. His Lok Sabha constituency, guys, is Jodhpur. Right, and recently Swachh Bharat Mission, this should be SBM, Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen completed its first phase and its second phase has been launched. And the rural sanitation coverage in the country has increased from 38.7% to 100%. Right, and all the rural areas in all the states have declared themselves ODF as on 2nd October 2019. 2019 tak, 2nd October 2019 tak, sabhi rural areas mein ने अपने आप को डिक्लेयर कर दिया था एज ओपन डिफिकेशन फ्री. ओके, सो दिस वाज अबाउट द स्वच्छ भारत केंद्रस एंड अदर देन दिस राष्ट्रीय स्वच्छता केंद्र एंड अदर देन दिस गाइस देयर इज वन कैंपेन दैट वाज आल्सो लॉन्च जिसका नाम है गंदगी मुक्त भारत. ओके, एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. द प्राइम मिनिस्टर इनॉग्रेट्स राष्ट्रीय स्वच्छता केंद्र ऑन 8th ऑफ अगस्त 2020 एट द गांधी स्मृति एंड दर्शन समिति एट राजघाट. वी हैव टू फाइंड द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग द Rashtriya Swachhata Kendras. Okay, so statement number 1 is it sketches the journey from Satyagraha to Swachhagraha. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And statement 2 is it imparts information, awareness and education on Swachhata. Yes, this is also correct. And it was first announced on 10th April 2019. No, it was announced on 10th of April 2017. Alright, on the centenary celebrations of Champaran Satyagraha. Okay, so this statement, guys, is incorrect and we have to find the incorrect statement. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option C. Only 3. And now question number 2. Along with the launch of Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra, a week-long campaign for Swachhata was also launched. What is the name of the campaign? So I told you that along with this Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra, a week-long campaign was also launched. Jiska naam hai Gandagi Mukt Bharat. Option B, Gandagi Mukt Bharat is the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 3, which is about the MOU that has been signed between CSIR and FSSAI. And this MOU is for collaborative research and information dissemination. This collaboration between these two institutions of India will contribute in fulfilling the vision of new food system dash. Alright, ye ek new food system hai guys, toh hume is new food system ka year hume yahan pe identify karna hai. Okay, so let us first discuss about this MOU. So recently this agreement was signed between CSIR and FSSAI. CSIR president is the Prime Minister of India and the current Director General is Dr. Shekhar Mande. Dr. Shekhar Mande. And FSSAI is chaired by Rita Teotia. Rita Teotia. And the newly appointed CEO is Arun Singhal. Right? So this is about CSIR and FSSAI. And now this MOU with CSIR will enable FSSAI to identify existing and novel technologies and programs related to food safety. Food safety se related jo bhi novel technologies hain, usko identify kar payega FSSAI after this MOU. It will be able to collect data regarding food consumption, kis level ka food consumption hai, kitna food consumption hamare desh mein hona chahiye, aur in future with the increasing population, kitna food consumption required hoga. Incidence and prevalence of existing emerging risk related to food safety. To develop a rapid alert system and to strengthen the quality assurance laboratory network. जो हमारे FSSAI के labs हैं, उनका जो quality assurance है, उसको strengthen करने के लिए मदद मिलेगी FSSAI को after this MOU with CSIR. And guys, if you talk about the new food system 2050, so according to this system, we will have climate friendly food production systems after 2050. मतलब we have to achieve this system so that we have till 2050 we have climate friendly food production system. We have to ensure the conservation of land and water resources. साथ ही साथ हमें food system को maintain करने के साथ साथ हमें land और water resources की conservation पे भी ध्यान देना है. We have to reduce food loss and food wastage across the value chain. We have to increase small scale production units for self sustaining local economies, because 2050 तक जो हमारी population होगी वो काफी ज्यादा increase हो चुकी होगी. सो हमें स्मॉल स्केल प्रोडक्शन यूनिट्स को इंक्रीज करना पड़ेगा ताकि हम सेल्फ सस्टेन बन सकें. एंड यूज ऑफ एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली पैकेजिंग अल्टरनेटिव्स एंड आल्सो द रीपर्पजिंग ऑफ वेस्ट. सो दिस इज अबाउट द न्यू फूड सिस्टम 2050. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. सो देयरफॉर गाइस द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी व्हाट? न्यू फूड सिस्टम 2050. ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. The Food Safety Standards Authority of India, FSSAI, is selected as one of the 10 global organizations for the Food System Vision Prize by Rockefeller Foundation, Second Muse and OpenIDEO for the Eat Right India movement. So, ek movement chalaya gaya tha by FSSAI that was known as Eat Right India movement. Us movement ki wajah se inko FSSAI ko prize mila hai jiska naam hai Food System Vision Prize. And we have to find the incorrect statement about the Food System Vision Prize, right? So let us first discuss about the news. So recently FSSAI has won this prize jiska naam hai Food System Vision Prize. And this award, guys, recognizes organizations that have developed an inspiring vision of the regenerative and nourishing food system that they aspire to create by the year 2050. 2050 tak agar koi aise organization hai jo ki nourishing food system ko create karna chahti hai ya unhone ek inspiring vision rakha hai ki ek wo ek nourishing food system ko create karenge, to ye award us सिस्टम को, उस विजन को रिकॉग्नाइज करता है. ओके, एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द ईट राइट इंडिया मूवमेंट, सो इट वाज लॉन्च्ड बाय एफएसएसएआई इन द ईयर 2018 ऑन द वर्ल्ड फूड डे. सो कैन यू टेल मी द वर्ल्ड फूड डे, जो वर्ल्ड फूड डे का डे कौन सा है? कैन यू टेल मी द डेट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड फूड डे? राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट्स. दिस मूवमेंट एम्स टू स्ट्रेंथन इश्यूज अराउंड फूड सेफ्टी एंड इट ब्रिंग्स टुगेदर थ्री ऑनगोइंग इनिशिएटिव्स ऑफ एफएसएसएआई, व्हिच इज Safe and Nutritious Food Initiative that is focused on social and behavioral change around food safety and nutrition. The Eat Healthy Campaign that is focused on reduction of high fat, sugar and salt foods in the diet. And Food Fortification, which is focused on adding key vitamins and minerals in 5 staple foods, which are wheat, flour, rice, oil, milk and salt. Okay, so this is about the Eat Right India movement. Now let's move on to the question. So we have to find the incorrect statement about the Food System Vision Prize. It aims to develop a vision of the regenerative and nourishing food system that they aspire to create by the year 2050. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It is an invitation for organizations, universities, institutions, companies, cooperatives and partnership. Yes, this is also correct. A prize of $2 million will be distributed among the winners. Yes, this is also correct. Guys, if ye sari cheez humne discuss nahi kari thi, this we will cover through this questions, okay? It seeks to develop actionable solutions and become protagonist in their own food future. Yes, this is also correct, guys. तो जो हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है वो ऑप्शन ई होना चाहिए, विच इज द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट दैट द विनिंग इनिशिएटिव विल बी अडॉप्टेड बाय अदर कंट्रीज. ऐसा कोई प्रोविजन नहीं है, दैट द विनिंग इनिशिएटिव विल बी अडॉप्टेड बाय अदर कंट्रीज ऑल्सो. राइट, एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, विच इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टूडे. So enhanced telecom and broadband connectivity will boost tourism and employment generation in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, give an impetus to the economy and raise standards of living. Better connectivity will also facilitate delivery of e-governance services such as telemedicine and tele-education. This statement had been said when the submarine optical fiber cable connecting Chennai and Port Blair was inaugurated. Which agency will execute this system? कौन सी एजेंसी है जो कि इस सिस्टम को एग्जीक्यूट करेगा? ओके, सो लेट अस फर्स्ट डिस्कस अबाउट दिस. सो रिसेंटली गाइस, प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया इनॉग्रेटेड दिस सबमरीन ऑप्टिकल फाइबर केबल कनेक्टिंग चेन्नई एंड पोर्ट ब्लेयर. दिस एंड फॉर दिस प्रोजेक्ट द फाउंडेशन स्टोन वॉज लेड ऑन 30th December 2018 एट द पोर्ट ब्लेयर. एंड दिस हैज बीन डन टू इंश्योर द फास्टर डिलीवरी and more reliable mobile and landline telecom services to Andaman and Nicobar Islands at par with the other parts of India. Okay, and the funding is by the Government of India through the Universal Service Obligation Fund under the Department of Telecommunications, Ministry of Communication. Universal Service Obligation Fund, guys, it is a non-lapsable fund. It is a non-lapsable fund established in the year 2002 for providing the quality information and communication technology services in the rural areas. This project will be executed by Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. Technical consultants will be TCIL and the project cost is ₹1224 crores. Okay, and this will boost guys tourism and employment generation. This will help in the employment generation in the areas of Andaman and Nicobar. In the education sector, it will enhance the e-learning and knowledge sharings, and it will provide a boost to small, medium and large enterprises through the platform of e-commerce. Okay. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option A, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. All right. Okay, so that's it for the session today. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. And for more sessions like this, do buy our paid courses of RBI, SEBI, NABARD, UGC. And aapko session kaisa laga? Please comment karke zarur bataye. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.